By faith we see the hand of God. In the light of creation's grand design. In the lives of those who prove his faithfulness. Who walk by faith and not by sight.
Good morning. Welcome to the Chester ARP Church Devotional Podcast. Clint Davis here. Hope you're well. Thank you for joining us. We read the Bible. We discuss it on this devotional podcast, 5 to 6 minutes per day. Thank you for joining us. If you're with us on Spreaker, thank you. Sermon audio, thank you. On the church app, thank you. We're excited to be here as we worship God and think through his word together on this podcast. Jerusalem Council, Acts chapter 15. Paul is going out. He's telling all these people about Jesus. The Holy Spirit's going forward, and all these people are coming to faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. They're excited. They're coming to know Jesus. Gentiles and Jews coming to faith. They're having to come together. This is a new day in the life of the religious landscape. Prior to this day, in which Paul is taking forward the good news of Christ, and before people are coming to know Jesus, and there was two divisions. There were the Jews who had worshipped and devoted themselves to the one true God of the Bible, and they had their laws, and they had their practices and their rituals. And then there were the Gentiles who did anything else, right? They worshipped any other god or any other religion or any other experience and had their own rituals. And now, through Jesus Christ, the world's coming back together. It's an exciting time in the life of the Christian church. People are coming to faith in the Lord Jesus, Jews and Gentiles. Now we got to figure out what to do with this, because now that the apostles have to gather together and say, all right, where do we go from here? Because now we're no longer separated in Jewish camp and Gentile camp. We're now together through Jesus Christ. We're one in Jesus camp. And so what do we do with this? How do we deal with it? Do we make Gentiles become Christian, become Jews as well as Christians? In other words, do we make the men be circumcised? And do we make them participate in all the feasts of the Sabbath days and all those kind of things? Or do we make the Jews change and give up those things? Or what do we do? And that's the question before the apostles here in Acts chapter 15. So we pick this up here. Acts 15, beginning in verse 1. But some men came down from Judea and were teaching the brothers, unless you are circumcised according to the circumcision of Moses, you cannot be saved. And after Paul and Barnabas had no small dissension and debate with them, Paul and Barnabas and some of the others were appointed to go up to Jerusalem to the apostles and the elders about this question. So being sent on their way by the church, they passed through both Phoenicia and Samaria, describing in detail the conversion of the Gentiles, and brought great joy to all the brothers. And when they came to Jerusalem, they were welcomed by the church and all the apostles and the elders. And they declared all that God had done with them. But some believers who belonged to the party of the Pharisees rose up and said, it is necessary to circumcise them and to order them according to the law of Moses. The apostles and the elders were gathered together to consider this matter. And after there had been much debate, Peter stood up and said to them, brothers, you know that in the early days God made a choice among you, that by my mouth the Gentiles should hear the word of the gospel and believe. And God, who knows the heart, bore witness to them by giving them the Holy Spirit just as he did to us. And he made no distinction between us and them, having cleansed their hearts by faith. Now therefore, why are you putting God to the test by placing a yoke on the neck of the disciples that neither our fathers nor we have been able to bear? But we believe that we will be saved through grace of the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, just as they will. I love this section of the book of Acts. Right? So these Jewish people, as I said in the introduction, they got to figure out what to do with this. And the Jewish leaders, the people, especially the people who come to know Jesus and trust in the Messiah, who were of the Pharisee party, of whom Paul himself was, were saying, you've got to make these men be circumcised. They've got to bear the outward mark of the people of God, just as the Jews do. They were holding on to their traditions and to their faith. Now, I think it's important to understand that there was no Christianity without a mark, right? The mark of the new of the Christian of faith in Christ, the mark of the New Testament, the mark of the church, was a mark of baptism. We're setting people aside. All these people had been baptized, and they were repentant. They believed, and they'd been baptized. So they bore the mark of God upon their lives. It just didn't show up in their anatomy. And so they were saying, "Well, you got to make these Gentile men be circumcised." Well, naturally, The Gentile men said, no, we're not doing that. We're not interested in that. I can understand why. We're not interested in that. And so they had this debate. And finally, Peter says, hey, listen, you know that in early days, back at the very beginning of the church, the day of Pentecost and following, God chose that that the Gentiles should hear the gospel and that they should come to faith. He's referring to a dream he had, a vision he had in Acts chapter 10. And they should come to know Jesus, and they should give their hearts to Christ, and they should live with them, and they live with him in a relationship, and they receive the Spirit just as we did. So therefore, why are we adding something to them? We couldn't bear that burden of being a law-abiding citizens of God because it was too great for us to bear. That's why Jesus had to come. So why should we expect our Gentile brothers to do that? Why should we lay a burden on them to bear that they could not bear? We could not bear. And that's Peter's question. And it's a great question. We'll hold it, and we'll talk about it more tomorrow. But it's a great question. If faith is in Christ and Christ alone, then our hope is in Christ and Christ alone. Nothing else matters but faith in Christ. You guys have a great day. God bless you. I'll see you tomorrow.